with the Gators cachet is. It's about the fun and gun. It's about the offense, and they've been missing that.
My pleasure to introduce to you our new head football coach, Jim McElwain. Jim?
For us to be a part of Gator Nation is something that means so much.
And you can put this one in the books. And they pick up the win here in the Birmingham Bowl.
Jim McElwain comes to Florida. He's able to develop relationships very quickly and all in a pretty stellar class.
Think about the history and tradition that is Gator football. I cannot tell you how proud I am to be a part of that.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the 2015 Florida Football Preview Show. I'm your host, Peter Burns, joined alongside former Florida Gator Chris Doering over there and former Arkansas Razorback quarterback Clint Sterner. Gentlemen, we get closer and closer to the season, getting ready to kick off. And let's tell you about the storylines in Gainesville. Jim McElwain, well, he's down there. 3 seasons at Colorado State, and now he finds himself in familiar territory in the SEC, where he won 2 national titles as the offensive coordinator at Alabama. And, of course, while he was at Colorado State, kept increasing on that win total, and he's got to find a quarterback. 2 options appear. Treyon Harris, who started 6 games last season but completed just under 50% of his passes, and redshirt freshman Will Greer, number 3-ranked dual-threat QB in the 2014 ESPN 300 defense. Looks to be strong again. Gators returned 7 starters to a D that ranked in the top 20 in FBS in both points and yards per game. All-American cornerback Vernon Hargraves, the 3rd, 13 pass breakups, tied for the most in the SEC. Only Ole Miss, the number 1 scoring defense in FBS last season, forced more turnovers than Florida's 30 among SEC teams last year. However, the Gators took away the ball more often. Florida forced a turnover on 18% of opponents' possessions, best in the SEC. So when we talk about the Florida Gators, it seems, gentlemen, we started with defense last year, and that's probably where we start this year. Clint, what are we going to expect to see out of this team?
Well, they have a really good chance to be the number 1 defense in the SEC, if not in the country. The luckiest man in coaching right now is Jeff Collins, the D coordinator that McElwain went with. He inherited a great, great group of players. One thing for me, I want to see how they replace Dante Fowler. And not necessarily his play on the field, his tone. He's a tone setter. He brings it every day at practice. He brings it in game. He's violent through the tackle. How do you replace that? It's not a personnel, but how do you replace that tempo and that approach every day?
Well, I think there's one guy that stood out to me in the preseason so far. That's Caleb Brantley. He's a guy that's been unblockable in practice. Jim McElwain's talked about his abilities. I think him, along with Taven Bryan, a guy that's from Wyoming of all places, these two guys are going to give you production to help fill that void from what Dante Fowler's departure leaves. I also think in terms of tone setting, Vernon Hargraves, everybody knows how great he is. I think he's the best player in the conference. So I think he rolls into that leadership role and really sets the tone for that defense heading forward.
You guys talked about some new players, but you also brought up a new defensive coordinator. Jeff Collins moves from Starkville down in Mississippi State to Gainesville, so he keeps the Ville part going. But how hard is that for a defensive coordinator to come in and you inherit a job that, frankly, was pretty good last year?
Well, it's not difficult at all when you inherit a job that returns this many key starters. 7 starters doesn't seem like a lot, but in the scheme of things, those starters are pretty dang good. Not to mention, the backups weren't bad. The freshmen that are coming in aren't bad. All in all, Jeff Collins has got a great, great situation right now.
And really, the scheme is very similar. What he's done in the past at Mississippi State is going to be what they're going to do as they move forward here in Gainesville. They like to blitz. There's a lot of chaos that's created. So I really do think it's going to be an offense that, or a defense, mind you, that's very similar to what these players have run under Will Muschamp. I think what they've done even further is simplified it to let these guys to play fast. And all the verbiage has been the translation from what they used previously. So they're not going to have to learn all new verbiage and kind of think. These guys are going to play fast because it's what they're used to. Jeff Collins has adjusted his thinking to what the Florida staff had used previously.
With Jeff Collins, do we expect to see a lot more blitzes? Or, hey, when it is your first year there, do you say, hey, let's just kind of be a little bit patient and make sure these cornerbacks here, they're awfully good on the sides?
Well, I hate to beat a dead horse, but he can do whatever he wants to do when you've got guys like this, particularly in the secondary. You've got guys that can man up any receiver in the country right now. And when you have that guy, a defense coordinator can do whatever he wants with the front seven. If Antonio Morrison comes back healthy, these guys are going to be very, very difficult to deal with for any offense, regardless of what conference they're in or what day you catch them.
Well, defense, their best friend is a good offense, and they need to find a quarterback down there because, frankly, since Tim Tebow departed following the 2009 season, Gators have failed to find stability in that position. Of the six QBs to start a game since Tebow, four of them transferred out, and none of them have a QBR over 56 for their Florida careers. Tebow's career QBR was 83. Here's Coach McElwain on his QBs.
They've been splitting the reps, with all the different groups. I think both of them have had good days. Some have, they've had an off day here and there. I like where they're at, both of them. I feel comfortable with both of them. I think, we'll see after this. I really, I haven't put a deadline, if that's what you're asking. What I want to do is I want to see them take ownership.
Now, Coach McElwain is not alone when having to deal with quarterback battles. It seems like half of the SEC is doing it right now. But, Chris, when we look at Treyon Harris, the guy who started a couple games last year, what do you expect to see from him, and what is his ceiling?
Well, I'll tell you what. He's not a guy that's going to knock your socks off with his measurables. He's not a guy that necessarily impresses you with his arm strength. But what he is a gamer. The guy, when he gets under center and the lights are bright, he makes plays. And I think that's something this offense is going to need. I don't think he's going to be the prototypical Jim McElwain quarterback as you get further into his time in Gainesville. But I would think what he does bring is that X factor, the ability to run that they're going to need. This offensive line has some holes. It's the deficiency on this offense. So creating plays, keeping plays alive, and avoiding the rush is something they're going to need. And that's what Treyon Harris brings.
Yeah, he is electric with the football in his hands. He's an animal.
So let's go quarterback on quarterback now. What does Will Grier bring to this Florida offense that makes you think, hey, maybe this is going to be the guy?
Well, he brings to the table a quarterback that has thrown a lot of footballs in high school. There is no substitute for experience. That guy's caught a snap or taken a drop and made a decision as many times as anybody in the country coming out of high school. He threw for 14,000 yards in high school, 31 touchdowns. I mean, his stats are through the roof. So this kid has absolutely got more experience than any other freshman in the country. And he has the ability, big arm. He moves well, rushed for 1,200 yards as a senior in high school. He does a lot of things really, really well that are going to allow him to be successful in this offense. With a great OC, the kid has a chance.
Speaking of an OC, we were just talking about Jeff Collins, the new defensive coordinator, what that plays into. Doug Nussmeier, the new offensive coordinator coming in from Michigan. Which one of those quarterbacks fits into what Nussmeier's trying to do?
I do believe that long-term it will probably be Will Grier. But the thing that these coaches need to get out of these guys is some consistency. Consistency is the term. Consistent teaching. You know, these guys have had 7 wide receiver coaches in the last 7 years, 3 offensive coordinators now in the last 4 years. So it really needs to have that consistent message and some development. The players are there. They've got talent. They've recruited top 5, top 10 talent recruiting classes the last few years, but the development just hasn't been there. And I think that's what Doug Nussmeier and Jim McElwain do very, very well, is develop the talents on the roster.
Well, Grier understands the details of the game. It's not just about catching the snap and throwing the football. It's about the timing of drops. It's about you get in the red zone, the windows get smaller. You got to rip the football. You can't turn it over. You can't have penalties. You can't have sacks in the red zone. Those are the things that this offense, along with this great defense, is going to have to do well. And if they do that well, they're going to have a chance to win every football game.
And that's one of the reasons why there's a lot of fans are excited about Jim McElwain taking over the helm down there in Gainesville. Well, coming up in just a bit, a new show, SEC Inside, takes its turn in Gainesville as head coach Jim McElwain tries to turn things around for the Florida faithful. And I recently sat down with the head man himself, Coach Mack. He fully understands the work he has ahead, but also the opportunity given.
You know, you lay awake at night knowing what you have to do, and yet at the same time, it's unbelievable to have this opportunity at a place like the University of Florida. Obviously,
Well, 26 years ago, the Florida Gators hired an offensive guru. You may have heard of him, named by Steve Spurrier. He instantly upgraded the offense as Florida scored 13 more points per game and more than double their passing yards per game in this first season. Like 1989, Florida went 7-5 and averaged under 180 yards passing yards a game. Can McElwain have the Spurrier effect? Well, I sat down with Coach Mack to discuss, among other things, living up to the expectations that were already in place when he arrived.
First-year head coach of the Florida Gators. So, Coach, when did it set in for you that you would become a SEC head coach?
Well, I'm not sure it has still. There's times that, you know, you lay awake at night knowing what you have to do, and yet at the same time, you know, it's unbelievable to have this opportunity at a place like the University of Florida, obviously in the SEC. It's something special.
And what'd you inherit when stepping into that role?
You know, it's, you know, Gator Nation, something pretty special. And yet, you know, a team in a program that knows how to win. You know, Coach Muschamp did an outstanding job in a lot of ways, and you can see some of those things that we need to continue to build on. And, you know, some of the things that we need to do to, you know, put our face on it a little bit and help it get better. That's really what we're here to do. And you know, I've never really been real patient anyway.
On the move, find a spot, clear the field. Here we go. Let's go. Next up. Next up. Let him set it. Let him set it. See it? Throw it.
Accurate every rep. All right? Every rep's important. You guys are getting better at the tempos.
You went from 4-8 at Colorado State. A couple years later, you're 10-2. So how much patience do you have about turning this program around quickly?
Well, you know, I think one thing to know, obviously, is in the SEC, you're playing week in and week out. It's an unbelievable league. As it was, you know, at the level we were at Colorado State, recruiting's got to really pick up. We've got to make sure we're getting those pieces that in some explosive playmakers especially, as we move forward, that, you know, can help, you know, create some points and do some things offensively in this league.
Spent 4 years and won two national championships down in Tuscaloosa with Nick Saban. What did you learn from that program that you're going to bring to Gainesville?
You know, there was so much that we were able to learn, and yet so much along the way. I've been able to be around some great coaches, and you know, one thing Coach Saban I thought was really good at, you know, is a couple things is, you know, make sure you work hard, be complete in what you do. You know, that's simple. And he also told me on the way out the door to Colorado State, he said, whatever you do, you got to do it your way, you know, and implement the principles, the foundations and fundamentals of being successful, but make sure you put your own spin on it.
Hey, do me a favor today. Look at what colored jerseys we're in. Okay, so what's that mean? Throw it to the guys in the white jerseys.
Give them a little something at the mesh point.
Tell you one thing, be a good day to be on a boat.
You bring Jeff Collins over as defensive coordinator from Mississippi State. What's he going to bring to this Gators defense that's been pretty good over the last couple of years?
Yeah, really good. Obviously, his energy is infectious. He's a guy that's recruited the conference. He's coached in the conference. He's, you know, one that I think did an outstanding job with those guys, obviously, at Mississippi State. And really kind of fell out of the same tree, so to say, of the defense that we had been playing. So there's some familiarity there, and I thought the continuity was something that was very important.
How about offensively? Only 67 passing touchdowns in the last 5 years for the Florida Gators. How do you and Doug Nussmeier change that quickly?
Well, you know, there's a lot of things go into that, obviously, and Nussel, you know, it's something that's keeping him awake at nights too. But I think the first part is getting some continuity into what we're doing. You know, they've kind of been a change in philosophy for about 3 or 4 years, you know, and constant change really puts you in flux. And what we need to do is bring those guys together and solidify what we're going to do and keep building on their strengths as we work on the things that they need to work on.
Some hard-hitting questions now. How about this one? You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right. First concert you ever attended?
Oof. It'd be Mission Mountain Wood Band.
What was that again?
Yeah, you heard it.
Okay.
One of the great bands out of Montana. Look it up, man.
Okay.
It's something that should be on everybody's music collection.
It's going to make the iPod now. All right. What's the best piece of advice that anyone has ever given you?
You know, I really go back to, you know, just work hard and be complete in what you do. And that's really what it's all about.
You got a lot of fans that are looking to see what you're going to do with yourself and the Florida Gators program, Coach. Thanks for
that. Hey, I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Back here with Chris Doering and Clint Cerner. What's your favorite Mission Mountain Band song?
I got to download that. I haven't heard of those
you
guys.
You got to get it. Well, hey, Jim McElwain's not there to give music tips. He's there to win some ball games, and they got to do it getting it and passing the ball efficiently. Chris, when you look at that, what's he working with from an offensive standpoint?
Well, very limited in terms of pass receivers. There hadn't been a whole lot of success throwing the football. DeMarcus Robinson jumps off the board at you, but another guy that needs to be consistent. And a guy that everybody's kind of pinning their hopes on in Gainesville, Brandon Powell, who obviously is making that transition from running back to wide receiver. Can he be a guy that fits in as a solid number two? The coaches are betting on it, so we'll have to see the production.
I like Ahmad Fullwood. He's a guy that you saw take 186 yards in the bowl game. He's a big, big target. As an offensive coordinator, you've got to find a way to get that guy involved, right?
And that has something to do with it, of what his personnel, not his personnel players, but the personnel groupings at McElwain's.
Well, coach's job is to put their players in position to be successful. And what Jim McElwain is going to do is he's going to do that by personnel groupings, by tempo and alignment. Here you see a typical four wide receiver set. This is harking Gator fans back to the days with Steve Spurrier spreading it out, saying, hey, I'm going to put my four best wide receivers on the field. Do you have four or five defensive backs that can cover? And right here, just finding ways to get guys open in space.
Absolutely. You get a good four wide out spread set. It's even. The quarterback should know exactly what the defense is doing pre-snap and be able to make a good read.
Here's what I think Florida will do a lot of this year. This is a three tight end set. It's a run look, but with pass catchers like Ciante Lewis, Jake McGee, and DeAndre Goolsby, you create matchups by getting linebackers to have to cover athletic tight ends.
Yeah, you talk about the tight ends that Florida has. This personnel is a great set for them. What's most important though is the quarterback's clean. He's upright. They only throw the football when they rush four players and ask the quarterback to sit back in the pocket.
Now, what about some of the play calls he's going to bring from Colorado State?
Well, this right here is actually a quarterback's option. He sees an overload strong. He's going to shoot the ball out to one of his playmakers, get the ball out of the quarterback's hands, keep him upright, let the playmakers make plays, and that's a big time weapon for a quarterback.
Those are easy reads too. You're not asking them to have to look at something all that complicated.
Right, and here's a misdirection. They're going to fake the run left and the throwback either to tunnel screen or a quick screen. Again, getting the ball out of the quarterback's hands and into a receiver's hands that can make plays. Florida's got a couple of guys like that can make plays now, Doering. I know they're limited, but they got a couple of guys like
there's
that.
There's no Chris Doering right there. But we'll
they weren't
there.
Throwing me the tunnel screen back then.
What's the balance? What's the balance here? Are we looking 65 run, 65% pass? What do you think that'll be?
Well, I think they have to be 50-50. I think to develop the downfield passing game, you have to rely on Kelvin Taylor and get some production running the football. But if they get skewed one way or another, it's going to be a long season offensively.
All right. Just ready, because I'm getting ready to put you guys to the test. Are you ready to do that?
Bring it.
Okay, we're going to do that because we're in the business of analysis and predictions, so let's predict the entire Florida Gators schedule game by game. Clint Cerner, Chris Doering, going to get it locked and loaded. But first, it's SEC Inside at Florida, an inside access look at fall camp.
Today, a lot of good things. Learn, focus, detail. That's what it's got to be all about. All right, guys, we're going to have a heck of a football.
And that ball was picked off. Why do you want to test Vernon Hargreaves?
One of the best in the country.
It's been a season of change in Gainesville with the hiring of head coach Jim McElwain. And the Florida faithful, what they're hoping with him comes a spark to the offense that's quite lacking in the last couple of years. After all, he did coordinate two national championship offenses at Alabama from 2008 to 2011. And he's front and center in a preview of our new series, SEC Inside.
Beautiful day today, by the way.
Man, this is great.
Really nice. Yeah, that's off the ocean, right? We got to get him rolling just a little bit today.
Here we go. Now keep it on his inside eye. First guy, hit it. Good. Does that make sense? Squeeze it to where they got no room to run. Okay?
Ready. Hey!
Good. Let's go, guys. Find the coach. Here we go. Playing fast today now. Playing fast. In and out of breaks. I mean, it's really simple. It's a detail that helps you be good, man. Hot guys, take a shot.
Jeez, Louise, guys.
I got him. He got protection, man. That linebacker came. South Bengal. It don't matter. He's never passed color. You know what I'm getting at?
We on teach, right?
Josh, just push off it, right? Just put your weight on it. Weight on left foot.
Push. Push.
Push.
Yeah.
No, I mean, it's just a comfort thing. Whatever you feel is comfortable. I'm just trying to help you get the ball out of your hand. There. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about right there. That's good, man. Okay, we're going right to fastballs, right to fastballs. Let's get in and get our motors running a little bit. Okay, start it a little slow. What's it all about? Fast start, right? Fast start and finish. Now, quicker. God dang, shuffle set, fall out. Run fast and finish. Dang it. What don't we understand about moon and sun? Somebody couldn't get the Randy Johnson fastball right there. I mean, that was a big unit on the ball right there, just piping that thing. There it is right there. Good, just like that. Perfect, good. Good job, D-Rod. Did a little better there. You jumped and then you tried to go,
coach,
and then you went, boom.
Hey, coach, what I did, happening anymore.
Fall out. Today, a lot of good things. Learn, focus, detail. That's what it's got to be all about. All right, guys, we're going to have a heck of a football team.
That's a great look at fall camp, but SEC Insight is going to go into game weeks. Wednesday on September 9th, Florida Gators and Vanderbilt will take a look at SEC Insight. But now, back with Chris Doran, Clint Sterner, the tough part. Now we start looking at the 2015 schedule for the Florida Gators. I asked the guys to go ahead and fill in the W's that they at least agreed on. The rest of it, not so much. So let's start. 9-26. Against the Tennessee Volunteers, a team that a lot of people think are up and coming in the East.
This is, to me, the most important game of the season for the Gators. This is an opportunity to create some momentum early in the season or put yourself in the tank with a loss to a team you haven't lost to in 10 years. I really think that this is going to be tough for Josh Dobbs going into the Swamp. He put up big numbers last year, but look who it was against: South Carolina, Kentucky, Vanderbilt. I want to see him do it against the best of the best.
I agree. Defense, Florida's defense wins this game.
So you got a W, big W, all right? So you're starting off 4-0 to start the season. Now, Ole Miss, what do you like?
Ole Miss is going to be a tough one. They're one of those experienced, a ton of talent. That star-studded class that Hugh Freeze recruited a few years back is of age right now. I like Ole Miss beating these guys with a close one.
Two great defenses, but I think the difference here is whoever ends up being the quarterback for the Rebels is going to have to go into the Swamp early in the season. I don't know that they're going to be ready for that. I'm going with a win for the Gators. You got them as a loss.
I'm the tiebreaker right now. Sorry, Gators. I believe that's going to be a loss. At Mizzou.
I think Missouri, that's a tough place to play for the Gators. Long road trip. They've lost to them badly the last 2 years. I think they lose that one.
I think it's a win. Again, that defensive experience and talent is hard to overcome. Missouri's got some young guys playing for them. I like Florida to win that game.
Oh, Florida Gator fans, you're going to hate me right there. I believe that's a loss. Just because Columbia, that's a tough place to play. At LSU.
I think that despite the quarterback issues with the Tigers, I think Florida, that's a tough road game. They're going to lose that game.
It doesn't matter who the quarterback is. You go to LSU, it's tough on you. I like LSU in that game as well.
There you go. A loss, the big Georgia game. When you look at that, and then the rivalries in the SEC, Florida-Georgia's right up there.
One of my favorite games in college football, the Florida-Georgia game. I love Florida in this football game.
I differ there. I think that the running game, Jeremy Pruitt's defense, is going to be the difference in this one. So I will take it as a loss, unfortunately, for the Gators.
Go ahead and put a loss up there. I apologize. Yell at Dari, not me, for this stuff. At South Carolina?
I think we both agree they're going to win that game at South Carolina. That's a tough game usually. And then Florida State here in the swamp. I don't think the Gators are quite back to being level with the Noles yet. I think they lose that one at home.
Yeah, it's hard to argue. Florida State, they're national champion caliber football team. I don't think Florida's ready for those guys either.
So that's a loss right there. So 7-5 first season for Jim McElwain.
I think that's an improvement from where they were.
We'll see how it is. We appreciate you guys watching 2015 Florida Football Show.